fancy a look at the list, do you? Anything catch your eye? Think you can help? Clive! Anything catch your eye?
The High Cardinal, here in Northreach.
That's what I heard.
The Dominion's all but done for.
And it's lucky we stayed here.
Sell anything today?
As much as you, I'll wager.
It was a time the market stalls were lined with all manner of goods from the four corners of Valisthea. Now, we're lucky to find an unbruised pip or a decent loaf of rye.
Half of what comes in is barely fit for pressing, let alone eating.
Flags, icons, whites and wolves. And then there's the skies. Seems to me the realm's had enough of our antics, and this is her way of finishing us off.
Fresh corn and carrots. Skirrets and leeks.
The garrison salvaged what they could from more, but...
That grain won't last us through the winter, will it?
And to think, I would be lying under a pile of rubble in Twinside.
If you'd ever got as far as setting out, yeah.
Was that shouting I heard from the barracks?
Could be trouble again.
Oh, that sellsword the dame's so fond of. That was some fine work you did up in Moor. We'll see to our own affairs from now on, now. Duke's got big plans for the Empire.
Do you think he was the only one who survived?
Does it matter? He's the only one who came.
The captain wants 2 score pikeheads. And as many swords as you're able to muster.
And I want a new bearer who can keep my forge fired. Looks like neither of us are getting what we want.
One at a time now. It's enough for everyone.
Thank you. We won't forget this.
We don't have much. But the dame had us empty the Vale's larders to see these poor souls fed. Because that is what we do.
Things are about to change around here. You wait and see.
The Duke will be here anon. See to it that he's made welcome.
Yes, my lord. A whole day to dry some bloody linens.
Well, what do you think?
What do I think? I think if we followed his lead, the town wouldn't stand a chance.
We already have a leader in the Dane. And from the pot came a terrible cry. Give me an elixir! Give me an elixir!
And did they give him one?
And why should we welcome a man who abandoned us?
Ask the men of the garrison.
And you're just gonna fall into line?
What else can I do? I'm a soldier.
It's not only control of the garrison he wants, it's the whole of Northreach.
I don't trust this Duke. If we're not careful, he'll undo all the Dane's hard work.
Oh, Clive. What am I to do? My wards and I may soon be without a home.
What's happened?
The High Cardinal has descended from his lofty throne and taken up residence here in Northreach.
The High Cardinal?
Leader of the Council of Elders, second only to his radiance at the head of the Imperial Government. Not that any of those things still exist. Now he goes by his noble title, the Duke of Oriflam.
And what does he want with Northreach?
He wants to transform it into a military stronghold, a foundation upon which to build a new Sambrek. He's already secured the support of the various army remnants, with promises that they shall be afforded the respect they deserve in his empire. One built on the confiscated property of the people.
He would rob the populace to pay for it.
Believe me. I have used every means of persuasion to discourage him from this folly. But for whatever reason, he will not listen to me.
What does Captain Philippe make of this? When the town was under attack, it was him the soldiers rallied around. Couldn't he use that influence again?
How? By speaking out against one of the most powerful men in Sambrek. A man whose stated aim is to revive the Empire Philippe's comrades swore to serve, and to improve the soldiers' lot within it. The captain can offer them a regular supply of gruel, and an occasional trip to the Vale to help them forget the terrors they face each day. The Duke offers them a vision of strength and safety. No. Any attempt to incite mutiny would cost Philippe the support of his men. If it did not cost him his life. But given the mood around town, mutiny may yet be unavoidable. The people have little appetite for further deprivation. Least of all when it serves only to elevate others.
Who could blame them?
Clive, would you appeal to the Duke on my behalf? For your services to Northreach? You have the respect of the soldiers, and they will take you to His Eminence if you ask them. And unlike Philippe, no bonds of loyalty prevent you from speaking your mind to the man. Well, will you try? You could hardly fare any worse than I did.
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you, Clive.
Tell me then, where will I find this Duke of Oriflam? In the garrison?
Overseeing the troops, yes.
All right. Wish me luck.
The fact that the soldiers trust you may well carry some weight with the Duke. He needs their support, after all. I only hope that you can make him see sense before he tears the town apart.
I may have met this Duke before, at the remembrance ceremony. Let's hope I didn't make a strong impression.
We already have a leader in the Dane!
Halt. Oh, sorry about that. You're the Dame's man, aren't you? You got some business with the captain?
No, actually. With the Duke. I was hoping I might be able to speak with him.
We're under orders not to let any civilians pass. But you should be all right. His Eminence has heard all about you and your heroics. Wait here. I'll go and ask.
So, you are the sellsword who lent his aid to the garrison. The Empire owes you a debt, and I shall see it repaid. But tell me, is it wealth that you seek, or favor?
Neither, Your Eminence. I thought only to inquire about your plan to turn Northreach into a stronghold.
Ah, I see. You are worried the expanded garrison will render your services redundant. Yet you needn't be. A proud fighting man like yourself shall always have a place here. Pride of place, in fact. For too long has the contribution of the noble soldier been underreckoned. But no more. For it is they who shall see the Holy Empire rebuilt, beginning right here in Northreach.
Why here, Your Eminence?
The town has been fortunate enough to escape largely unscathed from the recent troubles. Her defenses are sound, and her garrison well-prepared. Which is more than can be said for Oriflam or Twinside. The Empire wants for a capital, and I believe Northreach to be the perfect place. With Caer Norvant as her citadel. Once we have seen to the refortification of both the town and the castle, we need only build a wall around both to create a city that would be the envy of the twins. Plans are already underway for the construction. Soon enough, these thralls shall learn that they are no match for the might of Sanbrek.
I fear you underestimate how dangerous these creatures are, Your Eminence. Should they return in force, you will need all the people of Northreach to come together in defense of the town. Something they may be loath to do if they've been deprived of their worldly goods.
The people will do as their leaders command. If Sanbrek is to be rebuilt, she will require a functioning government. One whose authority is beyond question. That is why this levy is necessary. So that any man who wishes to join the army might do so and be fed, outfitted, and paid as befits a defender of the Empire. And yet there are those who persist in peddling the treasonous lie that I seek to steal from the people and drive them from their homes.
I suspect they're afraid of losing what little they have left.
Precisely. The common folk have little and less, and you mean to deprive them of even that. You would sow the seeds of your new empire in your own salted earth.
Sabine, we have discussed this.
Yes, and I told you then how putting the empire before her citizens would lead only to revolt.
Without an empire, there are no citizens.
And in yours, there will be only beggars. Is that what Grieger wills for her people?
Do not take her name in vain, Sabine.
I'll come back later. A citizens' revolt. I wonder what the people really think of the Duke's plan. It wouldn't hurt to ask them, I suppose. Let's begin with those on the other side of the wall.
So, you were right about the High Cardinal.
I'd rather I was wrong.
I've been hearing a lot of talk about a certain Duke.
Nothing good, I'll wager. Going around acting like he owns the place. And with hardly a word to the dame. This is her town, not his.
I take it you'd rather she was in charge.
As far as I'm concerned, she still is. Just need his eminence to sod off back to Oriflam. The dame actually cares about this town, unlike the Duke. He's only interested in picking our pockets to line his own.
Sell anything today?
As much.
The garrison salvaged what they could for the war.
A question, if you don't mind. What do you think of the Duke of Oriflam?
Don't get me started. You build a life for yourself somewhere, earning for some noble to turn up and tell you you've got to hand it all over to him. If he thinks his name and his chains give him the right to empty our purses, he's in for a rude awakening. We'll do whatever it takes to keep what's ours. Whatever it takes. If he comes calling, the only thing I'm giving the Duke of Oriflam's a piece of my mind. Maybe a smack in the gob.
Did you think I would be lying under a pile?
All right, there. What is it you're after, sir?
Just your opinion, actually. I wondered what you thought of the Duke of Oriflam.
Oh, him. Not much. None of us traders do. It's thanks to nobles like him that we had to set up shop this side of the wall in the first place. Couldn't have the rabble getting any closer to the Holy Capital, could they? And now he's trying to drive us out completely, threatening to take everything we got from us if we don't clear off. If the dame said she wanted him run out of town, I'd be straight through that checkpoint, tar bucket in hand.
Well, the people seem united enough. What about the soldiers?
The Duke might have soldiers at his beck and call, but us common folk follow the dame, and no one else.
Was that shouting I heard from the barracks?
And you're just gonna fall into line?
Excuse me, do you have a moment? I wondered if you'd mind sharing your thoughts on the Duke of Oriflam.
Well, he's made a lot of enemies coming in the way he did.
But I mean, look around us. You can see the state the realm's in.
The traders might not like having the screws put on them, but if they volunteered a few more of their hard-earned gil before things got bad, maybe they wouldn't have to. I think the Duke's got a point when he says rebuilding the Empire is the best way of making sure we're all protected. And if that means people who don't know one end of a sword from another have to make way for those who do, well, that's just how it goes. I mean, it'd be nice if we could all do whatever the hell we wanted and not end up being torn to shreds by a swarm of fiends. But we can't, so we've got to make sacrifices, just like the Duke of Oriflam says.
It's not only control of the garrison he wants, it's the
Well, what do you think?
What do I think?
We already have a leader in the day.
One at a time now. There's enough for everyone.
You. You're the one who was talking to His Eminence.
On the dame's behalf, yes. I was trying to persuade him not to take the people's goodwill for granted, but it seems my words fell on deaf ears. What do you think of his plans?
I'm a soldier, mate. He tells me what to do, not the other way round. Listen, I've got nothing but respect for the dame, but I've got a family to look after. That's where my loyalties lie, not with the town or the empire, but with my wife and children.
if the Duke can get us the men and the equipment we need to fight off those blue-skinned bastards, I don't care how he does it. I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for the Dame. But I'm with the Duke on this one. If turning this place into a fortress is what it takes to protect my family, I'll do it.
Sabine, you are embarrassing me.
You're embarrassing yourself.
I hear the Duke of Oriflam plans to turn this town into some sort of fortress. Do you think that's a good idea?
It's not for me to say. All I know is that unless the Emperor orders me otherwise, His Eminence's word is law.
Look,
no one likes all these taxes and tariffs, but empires don't come for free. Once Sandbrak is back on her feet, we'll all reap the benefits.
Let's see what Philippe makes of all this.
What the common folk don't understand is, this is for them too. Either we turn the Empire back into a force to be reckoned with, or we live in fear the rest of our lives.
A whole day to dry some...
Welcome back. Wraiths give you any trouble?
None worth mentioning. They're staying put for now.
Captain, do you have a moment?
For you? Certainly. Clive, wasn't it? Thank you for last time. How can I help you?
I wanted to ask you about the Duke of Oriflam. Do you intend to go along with his plan?
But to tell you the truth, I'm in two minds. It's my sworn duty as a captain of the Imperial Army to obey his orders. But I can't say I agree with him.
Philippe, I remember you saying that you became a soldier to protect the people you loved. The Dame included.
That's right. I did.
Well, she doesn't agree with the Duke's orders either. She thinks they could tear Northreach apart.
And she's probably right. Thank you, Clive. I know what I need to do now. Protecting the people I love is what matters. Doesn't matter how. Well, duty calls, so I better go. Thanks again.
It seems Philippe wants to do the right thing, at least. I expect Isabel will be pleased to hear that, if nothing else.
Sabine, you are embarrassing me.
You're embarrassing yourself.
And you're just gonna fall into line.
I don't trust this Duke.
Ah, Clive. How did you fare? Were you able to speak with the Duke?
I was, but...
So Northreach is to be a fortress after all. Well... it will certainly help to hold back the thralls. There's no denying that. Though I doubt it will come as much consolation to the townspeople whose worldly goods are confiscated to pay for it. They deserve to be heard, Clive. To have a say in this new empire the Duke means to build.
Sadly, His Eminence values their obedience more than their opinions. and hopes to reassert the authority of the state. I fear he sees the people as mere pawns on his chessboard to be sacrificed for the greater good. Needless to say, they themselves are of a different opinion, and would rather their destinies were in your hands. The soldiers, meanwhile, are content to follow their orders. And not just because of the Duke's rank, but because of his vision.
I thought as much. Had I sworn to protect Sambrek, I dare say I too would want nothing more than to see it rise from the ashes. Thank you for trying. But the battle is lost.
I don't know about that.
What happened to your uniform?
I handed it in, along with my resignation. Told the lads I wished them well, but that I owe it to those I love to call it a day.
But why?
Because I realize what really matters to me. Not following some nobleman's orders for the sake of it, but protecting what I care about. Protecting Northreach. I honestly don't know when those monsters will return, but I'm certain they're not finished with us yet. And when they do come back, we need to be ready for them. We need to stand together, all of us. And with you to lead us, m'lady, I reckon we can do it. It was you who finally convinced me, Clive. There's no point following orders if they go against everything you believe.
Indeed.
All of us, standing together. That has always been Northreach's best hope, and one which still lies within our grasp. We have only to turn our attentions to the true enemy. Thank you, Philippe, for showing me what I must do.
Anything for you, m'lady. Speaking of standing together, would you mind if I borrowed a few of the lads from the Vale to help keep watch around the town? I fear His Eminence has loftier tasks in mind for the guard.
Not at all. Be my guest.
Wouldn't be the first time.
There may be hope for Northreach yet. Especially with men like you and Philippe to champion our cause. I, for my part, shall continue to work upon the Duke, in the stubborn belief that I might still tempt him into joining hands. But I suspect I shall have to call upon your aid again. Until then, Clive.
Until then.
Despite my repeated advances, His Eminence has proven a difficult conquest. Fortunately, I am nothing if not persistent. But, be that as it may, I might yet need you to press the point.
It's not only control of the garrison.
What say you then? Will you stand with me against my father?
Of course we will! This is our town!
How long will it take to repair Cairnorvent?
That depends, your lordship. Much of the fort will need rebuilding entirely.
One at a time now.
What's happened? To the gate. You're right, old Beric.
They're saying Twinside's gone.
Clive. You'll be pleased to know that the negotiations are progressing well.
That is good news.
Yes. Our comrade in Randala has just sent word that the contract should be signed very soon. but I still have much and more to prepare. It's a huge undertaking moving this many bearers at once. You couldn't do me a quick favor, could you?
What is it this time? More wild beasts?
Nothing like that. I just need you to go over to the caravans and ask El how long we have until the bearers arrive. Find out exactly how much faster I need to get all these supplies moved.
All right. I'll go and ask.
Thanks, Clive. I owe you one. Last I heard, the contract was all but signed. Hopefully El knows when the bearers are due to arrive now.
Don't blame yourself, El. This is their fault, not yours.
I know, but...
No buts about it, all right?
Is something wrong?
Vonnie came to give me a message from our intermediary. The talks with the Republican army have fallen through. They've reached an agreement with the Silver Peak Consortium instead. Though prices have fallen of late, we deliberately offered above the going rate to try and deter other bidders. But the consortium offered double what we did, and the army jumped at the chance.
And you had no opportunity to make a counteroffer?
None at all. And we were so close.
El? What's happened? I saw Vonnie leaving. She didn't look happy.
And with good reason.
But I thought we were the only ones the Fist were speaking to about the bearers. How did the consortium even find out about this?
It's not so surprising. They have ears all over the Republic. This isn't over. The consortium will have to sell these bearers eventually, and at the price they paid, buyers will be few and far between. I'm going to Randalar myself.
Alone? You sure that's wise?
Are you offering to be my bodyguard?
How kind. Meet me at the checkpoint near the capital gates. I'll send an owl ahead and request a meeting.
You go to Cashlock, Theo, and get everything ready. We've waited far too long as it is. Even if I fail to free these bearers, there will be others. Someone needs to prepare the place and keep any prowling beasts at bay.
Oh, and that's me, is it? Well, it looks like I'm following orders till she gets back from meeting the Silver Peak Consortium, who've been doing their best to undermine our scheme. She'll never join them after this, surely. No, she said it herself. She still has plans for Cashlock, even if this one falls through. She means to stay with us, then. I can't say I'm not happy to hear it, but... is this what she really wants?
You have to trust her.
You're right. It's what she wants now. And if El's off fighting for the cause, I should do my part too. So I bid you farewell and safe travels, my friend. I'll gather my men and leave for Cashlock. We'll make sure the place is well stocked and defended. You go to Randalar and see if you can stop my sister biting the consortium's heads off. If she won't consider her prospects, someone has to.
I'll do my best. All right. To Randalar, then. And better not keep Eloise waiting.
I think something might be wrong with Theo. He never plays with us anymore.
We want to cheer him up, but we don't know any good jokes.
Water. God.
I wouldn't give for a hot meal.
Looks like this is the end of the road for us.
When are they gonna let us through?
Come on.
Run like the wind.
I didn't keep you waiting. Did you arrange to speak with the consortium?
Here they are now.
You wish to consult with me?
I did. It's about the bearers you recently purchased from the Fist. We had all but finished making arrangements to buy them ourselves, and then you stepped into the fray.
You misunderstand. The consortium had an interest in purchasing them from the very first. It was only our regard for you that kept us from bidding. But your hesitancy in accepting our offer to you suggested that the regard was not neutral. And so we resumed our business.
I did not hesitate. I am simply not inclined to make such decisions without first giving them due consideration. But what is done is done. Come then. How much do you want for them?
Alas, you are too late yet again. We rarely take on such unconventional merchandise without a purchaser in mind. The bearers belong to him now.
Who is your buyer?
A trader from across the water. A most demanding fellow, if it's any consolation. He insisted the bearers be fed, dressed, even given their own bunks for the voyage over. That's what you get when you deal with continental types.
I wouldn't know.
Oh yes, the culture on the continent is quite different to ours. They pay good money for bearers not fit for the knacker's yard, and treat them like kings. But as long as they pay...
That does sound unusual. No matter, then. If they've already left our shores, there's little that can be done. Allow me to withdraw my interest. And with it, my interest in joining your organization.
My associates will be sorry to hear that.
I'm sorry you weren't able to save them.
As am I. But I only have myself to blame. He was right, you see. The Silver Peak Consortium did intend to buy those bearers before I did. Their representative hinted at a possible purchase when he came to recruit me. I feigned interest in joining them in the hope he might be encouraged to tell me more. And he did just that. As soon as he left, I sent my own offer to Randalar.
So you never...
No. I entertained the consortium's proposal solely so I could learn more about those bearers. But I was a fool to think they wouldn't find out. I knew exactly who I was dealing with.
You tried.
I did. And if what he said was true, the bearers are to be well treated. Which is something, at least. But they deserved more. I wanted so badly to see them freed.
Eloise! Eloise! Word from Cashlock. The village is under attack. A pack of beasts have come down from the mountains, and there's a dragon at its head. Theo and the others are trying to hold them off as best they can, but the odds are against them. They need help, and fast.
Theo.
I'll go on ahead.
Thank you, Clive. I'll gather some men and join you there. Just make sure he's safe.
Hold on, Theo. I'm coming.
Please, you have to go and help him. You're my only hope. You're Theo's only hope.
Where's Theodore?
Upriver!
He led the dragon that way to keep it from the village, but the whole area is flooded with ether!
We just have to pray he makes it out in one piece.
I can do better than that. Torgal, with me. Time to fight. Where are you, Theo? Creatures have already turned. I can't waste any more time. I need to find Theodore before that dragon does. Looks like it's found me. This thing's turned as well. This isn't going to be easy.
Over here! All yours, Torgal!
Good.
Clive?
Theodore, you had me worried for... We have to get you out of here.
I think it might be a little too late for that. Bearer or no, there's only so much ether a man can take, and that Drake just wouldn't let me leave.
You have my thanks, Sid, for finishing what I could not, for keeping El's dream.
Theodore!
Thank you, Clive. I think I'll be all right now.
That was true bravery he showed. Leading the dragon away from the village like that. His first instinct was always to protect people. To put others' well-being before his own.
And now he's gone. Because I sent him to that place, against his will.
It wasn't against his will. He was ready to do whatever it took to show you he could stand on his own. So that you would finally be free to live your own life.
To live my own life? He never could come to terms with the choice I made.
What exactly happened? You once told me Theo was the first bearer you ever helped.
We grew up in Canva. We were born to one of the great trading houses. And I was chosen to inherit the family business. I had my father's head for figures, you see. Theo did not. While I studied the art of commerce, he played at soldiers instead. A late bloomer. In more ways than one. For unlike most bearers, it wasn't until his 15th summer that his powers awakened. My parents tried to drive him out of the house and into the care of the constables. But before they could, I took him into mine.
Theo told me something else. He clearly admired your devotion to the cause of freeing others like him from slavery. But he said you deserved a better life than this. He wanted to free you from what he called your bonds, just as you freed him from his.
I would be lying if I said I had not wondered from time to time how much easier my life might have been if I had allowed Theo to be taken and devoted myself to the family business instead. But I have never regretted the decision I made. Being with my brother meant more to me than tradition or reputation. I only had to look at him to remind myself of that night and the choice I made and the fact that I would make the same choice again in a heartbeat. He was never a burden. How could he even think that? If anything, I was the one who weighed him down.
You weren't, Eloise. He said to himself that he had always been grateful to you for saving him, and that he wanted to repay you by letting you live the life you were denied. Neither you nor Theo weighed each other down. You loved one another. You did whatever was necessary to continue living your lives together, and you always would have.
You're right. All I ever wanted, all I ever did, it was so we could be together. Oh, Theo, why did you have to... I know Theo wanted me to move on, but I'm staying here at the Crimson Caravans to continue our work. We can make a difference here. We can help people, save them. I need nothing more from life than that. So I'll carry on doing what we do, ensuring that goods, people, bearers get where they need to be, bringing smiles to people's faces, just like we always have, and to Theo's. Wherever he is. This is the life I have chosen. The life I will always choose.
I've made a choice of my own. To continue helping you however I can. Whenever you need it.
Thank you, Clive. Let's go on together then. For Theodore. The Crimson Caravans is my family business now, and I would not exchange it for the world. I brought Theo here to be safe, and I have never looked back since.
Eloise isn't the type to give up.
Maybe not, but she'll still need our support. We're all going to have to look out for each other now.
I've never seen Missel cry before.
Is Theo really gone then? He's never coming back.
If that's true, then we have to look after Missel, just like Theo looked after us.
Poor old Theodore. We may have been rivals in business, but I never wished him ill.
Who needs a porter when there's nowhere left to go?
This inky shroud does not portend ill weather, alas. I fear it is the harbinger of something far worse, as mankind strayed from the light of the heavens once more. Are we to be punished for our sins, like the denizens of Zemeckis?
What's happened? The guards at the gate drew right on me.
Well met.
fine choice. Many thanks. A fine choice. You've a discerning eye. You're welcome anytime.
Please, a piece of fruit.
Sid, you didn't happen to see anything out of the ordinary on your way here, did you? We've had reports of bearer transports being attacked along the roads, and they're not freeing the poor souls. They're reselling them on the black market. If we can catch them in the act, perhaps we can kill two birds with one stone.
Come on!
Faster!
Thank you.
Nice try.
When did you get so big?
Everything's back the way it was. I don't know how they did it.
I do. With a hell of a lot of hard work.
Take that, you naughty thief! And that!
Stop it, Renz!
Clive! To what do I owe the pleasure?
I just wanted to see how the town's been faring since you brought everyone together.
Since we brought everyone together, all is absolutely wonderful. Conrad and Natalie's hands remain safely away from each other's throats and firmly at the helm. Our stores are full, and the bandits still too disorganized to raid them. Just as the good Lady Jane and Lord Underhill intended.
Are you a lord? Lubor's going to be one too. They're going to make him the Lord of Dalimil, because of how he stopped all the grown-ups from fighting.
It's the Mayor of Dalimil, dear child. And the vote hasn't taken place just yet. But if the people wish me to lead them, I shall. And my first act will be to build a school so that menaces like you two learn not to interrupt your elders. Speaking of menaces, there may be a rather worrying one just over the horizon.
May there indeed.
I'm afraid the example Conrad and Natalie set in putting aside their differences and presenting a united front might have caught the bandits' attention. And they might have elected to take a similar approach. They have formed what one could call a League of Outlaws. And they grow more organized by the day.
But we'll fight them all off just like last time. No matter how many of them there are. Won't we, Lubor?
Of course we will. If we continue to work together, we can overcome any challenge we choose to face. The longer we avoid facing this one, the more difficult it will be. Until the only way to overcome it might be to run for the hills. Our best hope is to nip these efforts at organization in the bud. by finding those ne'er-do-wells who have yet to join the cause, and ensuring that they never do. Perhaps a certain Lord Underhill might be willing to lend us his aid once more?
How could I refuse?
Thank you, my lord. Victor will fill you in on the particulars. I have him stationed by the desert gate, receiving and collating reports from my scouts. Such an amenable soul. He reminds me of you.
I'll go and speak with him.
What's the difference between a lord and a mayor?
That's easy. One of them swings a sword, the other forges them.
Victor has been collating reports on the bandits' encampments. You'll find him by the desert gate. I'm sure if he has anything to ask of you, it will be simple enough.
A league of outlaws. Sounds like we have some competition.
He did it.
Fresh silks from the cabin.
We may have bloodied the bandits' noses, Cid, but it seems we have not yet broken their spirit. Victor is helping us to keep track of their movements. And we're very glad of his help. That man knows the desert and its dwellers like the back of his hand.
Still in Dalamil, Victor?
Ah, Cid.
I thought you'd have returned to Cosnes by now.
I did. Then I came back. I've developed something of a fondness for the place. And having worked so hard to see it saved from one fate, it would seem remiss to abandon it to another. A sentiment Master Lubor certainly isn't shy about exploiting. Hence my doing his bidding yet again.
You're not the only one.
What does he want you to do?
He asked for my aid in putting down the bandits. And he said that you might be able to help me find them.
Then you've come at just the right time. I was on my way to speak with Conrad about how to organize our forces. There are more camps in the vicinity than we can safely strike at once. But we must strike together, and we must strike soon at as many camps as we can. We can't give this league of theirs time to rally its forces.
All right. Which camp shall I take?
There's one upriver. Just out there, across the dunes.
Leave it with me.
The camp is in the desert to the north of here. You know what to do.
If those ne'er-do-wells want to band together, let them. They'll be no match for us.
Come on, run like the wind. Time to fight. Come on then, Toggle.
That's him! The one who killed Locke and Fingers! Take his head off! It's
over. I'd better let Victor know.
Cid, where are you? Ah, I see the bandits didn't pose you any trouble.
No, but that's not why you're here, is it?
No. Something's happened. We need you back in Dalimil.
What is it?
The whole town's in uproar. They're saying that Lubor is a bearer.
What?
Seems that one of our parties wasn't as thorough as they should have been. They let one of the bandits escape, and his escape route took him right through Dalimil. Some of the children spotted him, and he was about to silence them. And when Lubor felled him with a bolt of magic, and without a crystal.
But that's not possible.
It is if he's a bearer and has been hiding it all these years, which is what people are saying. If he has, well, I wouldn't blame him. No man is branded by choice. Still, all those people see is a man who's lied to them all his life. One who was made a leader of himself when the world believed he should have been a slave.
Fuck.
I don't know where we go from here, but I know one thing. Lubor needs all the friends he can get right now.
You're right.
And now everyone knows. I made it a habit to keep a crystal close at hand for just such an occasion. And when that occasion arose, I forgot to reach for it. Well, it was bound to come out sooner or later.
We're sorry, Lubor. We tried to keep running,
but we just couldn't anymore.
There's nothing to be sorry for. I rather enjoyed playing the hero for once. All that matters to me is that you two are safe.
Look at him talking to his betters like it's nothing.
All lies, I'll wager. Just like the ones he fed us all these years.
Once people make up their minds, it's hard to change them. We need to do something. And quickly. Convince the people not to let their prejudices blind them. Convince them that nothing has changed. That their enemy lies outside these walls, not within them.
You're right. We should speak to everyone.
I'm glad you agree. I'll handle the townsfolk. I'm a Dalmec born and bred. They listen to me. You head to the tavern. Make Conrad and Natalie remember who Lubor really is. They know that Lubor and I are friends. I might not make for the most impartial of interlocutors. Lord Underhill of Randalar's League of Merchants, however, is a trusted and impartial mediator of note.
I'll do what I can. Lubor, stay here with the children. I can't promise anything, but we'll try.
And that is all I can ask of you.
Why are you taking the bearer's side, Victor? Are you one too?
You know I'm not. Just listen.
What do you mean, don't jump to conclusions? He cast a spell without a crystal. What other conclusion is there?
Thank you, Clive. I'm sure you have better things to do with your time.
I don't care if Lubor's a bearer. He's still Lubor, isn't he?
The man with the sword was going to kill us, but then Lubor shot magic at him. It was amazing!
The bastard's been lying to us for as long as we've known him.
Can you believe we were going to make him mayor? He would have been the ruin of us all.
So, Lubor is a bearer, is he? He did well to keep it hidden so long. Unlike some of my fellow Dalimilians, the deception doesn't trouble me. Does the world know the full truth about them, I wonder?
None of the stalls were plundered this time, thanks Peter Gilbert.
How did your men fare? Any wounded?
The only thing wounded was our pride. We swore never to let a bandit set foot in this town again. We failed.
I think we'd better shut up shop for today. Give people one less thing to throw at him.
Sounds like something's happening in the square. I wonder what.
Daddy, what happened to your crystal?
It broke, son. And we won't be getting another.
Those damned blackguards took all my best pieces. Just my luck that we were robbed by connoisseurs.
That should be everything. Question is, where does Natalie want it all?
Gilbert, take this crystal. It's no more use than the bearer I sold to buy it.
I always thought it was the blessing I'd miss if the fang fell, not the miners.
Yes. You could always count on them not knowing the price of anything.
Why do they always have to make such a fuss outside? It's driving away our customers.
He knew all along that he was playing us for fools.
And we fell for it. We followed him. A bearer.
Forgive me for disturbing you, but could I have a moment of your time?
I've seen your face before.
As have I, Lord Underhill, wasn't it? Of the League of Merchants.
That's right. I wanted to speak to you about Lubor.
The rumors that he's a bearer. All true, I'm afraid.
He'll never be mayor now. Not if I have anything to do with it.
But what of his wares? Bearer or no, his steel is highly valued throughout the Republic. In this, at least, he's done the town a service. Might that not earn him a little leniency?
Leniency? He pretended to be one of us when he was laughing behind our backs all the while.
I'm sorry, my lord, but he lied to us. He lied to you. He cannot be trusted.
So what do you propose? Will you drive him from his home? Close his forge?
Perhaps. That is a question for the people of Dalimil. And they will thank you not to get involved.
The townsfolk have made their minds up. There was nothing I could do.
Nor I. Conrad and Natalie refused to consider anything but their own wounded pride.
You never know. Once their anger is cooled, they might see things differently. For now, we should report back to Lubor.
All right.
Why the hell would Victor take the bearer's side?
For a share in Lubor's ill-gotten gill, perhaps?
Go on, Cid. No sense stalling. Lubor needs to know the truth.
What do you mean, don't jump to conclusions? He cast a spell.
You may have your business interests to consider, my lord, but do not think you can sway us with your honeyed words.
Lubor has been lying to us from the beginning. How can we trust him?
Why didn't he tell us?
The man with the sword was going to kill us, but then Lubor shot magic.
I assume the situation is hopeless?
There's still hope. But...
but perhaps not in this lifetime, I think it's fair to say.
You mustn't think like that, Lubor. Give them time. They'll come around. We'll talk some sense into them in the end, you'll see.
No, you won't. And your efforts would be better spent elsewhere.
But Lubor...
Rosina would often tell me... that steel does not lie, that a blade is a reflection of the smith who forged it. To yourself be true, that was her point. Rather an ironic one when you consider that her life was taken with a blade of her own making. But I do not doubt that she was always true to herself and what she believed in, right to the end. And so must I be. I must do what I know to be right, no matter what others might think of me. And now, I know what that is. I must embrace my new role of villain so that the people of Dalamil have something to unite against. For only united can they hope to stand against the threat that awaits them. I'll need to make a suitably dramatic exit, of course.
Don't go, Lubor. You're the only one who was ever kind to us. We'll be all alone. Again.
Trust me, little ones. It is for the best that I go. Not only for the town, but for you, too.
How could it possibly be for the best? These children need you. The least you can do is give the townspeople a chance to change their minds.
They would not take it, Victor. It's over.
Over, you say? And so just like that, you're going to throw this town and these children to the wolves? I thought you were better than this. But it seems you had me fooled as well.
Victor.
Forget it. Do what you will.
Are you sure you're making the right choice, Lubor?
Of those available to me, I believe it's the best one. Yes. Ah, but where are my manners? Here, your reward for clearing out that bandit camp. Right then, I have packing to do.
If there's anything I can do, anything,
I'll bear it in mind. Thank you.
Why didn't he tell us?
If you're going to try and convince me to stay, save your breath. I will not put those children at risk.
I'm going to go with him.
Why is everyone being mean to Lubor? He didn't do anything wrong.
Why the hell would Victor take the bearers?
Why do they always have to make such a fuss outside?
In nicks and lumps, the lot of them. It's a wonder they can still
come back.
Mm, the stew's awfully thin.
Thank you. fancy a look at the list, do you? Here you go.
Seen enough?
How may I help you today, Clive? Here you are. All done?
I still say it were a compliment.
Say it all you like. It doesn't make it true. Ah, Clive. I was wondering when you'd arrive. Please tell me you've come to take our young prodigy here off my hands.
I'm not here for Mid. I need information on Ash.
Then why not ask Molly if you can look in one of her ovens? Go on.
As soon as the Enterprise is ready, we'll be setting out for Drake's Spine. And we're going to need a safe place to land.
Preferably one that won't see my ship blown to shit and splinters.
If it were that easy, do you think Walud would have resisted invasion for so long? Very little is known of Ash, and the information we do have is spotty and outdated. We have the good King Barnabas to thank for that. Walud's borders have been closed to outsiders since the day he seized the throne. If there is anywhere safe to land, you won't find it on my map.
Then tell us what we will find. I'm sure you know better than we do.
But no splinters!
All right, all right. If it will get you out of my hair. But interrupt me, and it's over. Understood? Barnabas Tharm, the one they call the Last King. Understand him, and you will understand the kingdom of Walud. Barnabas was only a boy when he arrived from beyond the southern seas, and barely a man before he united the ragged tribes of Ash. And having unleashed them upon the formidable Veldemark, he set his throne upon the ancient kingdom's ruins. The victory sent shockwaves around Valathea. Tales of Odin's might spreading through every court, parlor, and drinking hole in the realm. Note that this was in the year 843, and that the king still sits upon his throne some 40 years later, quite untouched by time. Walud's recent inaction left many wondering if Odin had lost his appetite for war. And yet here we are. The Einherjar was committed to the fray, a bold declaration of intent. Orcs swarm around Drake's Fang, and throngs of Akashic haunt canvas streets. Though how precisely the havoc they wreak serves Walud remains unclear. Regardless, if the order to attack truly came from King Barnabas, then one thing is certain. Walud has achieved the impossible and made bedfellows of beastmen and the Aether Adult alike. All of which is a roundabout way of saying that you will be in unknown territory when you set foot on Ash. Much of the continent has already been lost to the Blight. And what few ports remain will be fiercely guarded. And that is to say naught of its natural defenses. Offshore currents will cast an ill-equipped ship out to sea one moment, and dash it against the rocks the next. But then the Enterprise is anything but ill-equipped. And Mid has made land there before. Now, if only there were someone with an intimate knowledge of the Shadow Coast, and where a daring gentleman might put ashore. You see, Clive, you had the answer all along.
Do you think you can get us back to that beach, Mid?
Picked you up from it, didn't I? Not that it were easy. The currents were a rape bastard. But then, if it wasn't hard, it wouldn't be worth doing, would it?
Well said. Thank you, Lady Vivian.
If a few morsels of common knowledge and a sprinkling of tavern talk are worthy of your thanks, I wonder what genuine intelligence might earn me.
Probably more visits. Mid, I need everyone in the ale hall now. I'll fetch Joshua from the shelves.
Aye, aye, Captain.
What will it be today? How may I help you today? I have the details here. Here you are. Yes, perhaps a little revision might not go amiss. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
How do you split the sea, you reckon?
I reckon we're better off not knowing.
You need anything, you just ask. We might not have your uncle's resources, but resourcefulness, we've got in spades.
Stay strong. Ah, my Lord Marquis. It was the greatest honor of my life. But now, so I bid you. Your companions are kind indeed. I must admit, but I see now.
Yote, is anything the matter? You seem troubled. Perhaps I might be able to help.
My lord. Yes. Perhaps you might. It's your brother. His condition continues to worsen, though he does his best to hide it. The lesion on his chest pains him more with each passing day.
I had feared as much.
There are certain elixirs which can ease the suffering of those afflicted by the curse, but...
But?
But his grace's case is severe. The drafts I have been able to prepare for him thus far have ceased to have any real effect. So I consulted with Tarja and certain of my comrades among the Undying about the possibility of finding something stronger. And thankfully, a recipe was found. The only problem being that the critical ingredient is exceptionally hard to come by, and our supplies are almost exhausted. Unless we can secure more soon, your brother's anguish will likely become unbearable. My lord, I know that I have no right to make demands of you. But would you help? For Joshua's sake.
For Joshua? Anything.
Thank you, my lord.
So, what is this critical ingredient?
A rare herb by the name of stonerwort. It grows only where the ether is densest. The vigor it stores in its stems helps to counteract the curse. We discovered a patch near the aqueduct in Rosaria. But alas, yet more ether has erupted from the earth there recently, leaving the whole area flooded. The search continues for a new source. One that we might reach without being turned.
So it's only that you can't reach it. The stone and water itself is unharmed by the flood.
Well, yes, but...
Then I shall go in your stead.
Oh, but, my lord...
You've yet to find another source, correct? So for now, the aqueduct is our best hope. Besides, I'm a dominant. The ether can't hurt me.
Well, if you're sure, my lord... Stonerwort is easily identified by its blood-red blooms. Search around the aqueduct, and you're sure to find some soon enough. I shall remain here and prepare the other ingredients. I had only thought to ask for your assistance in finding a new source of Stonerwort, but if you're sure about collecting it from the flood by the aqueduct, I should be most grateful. My lord.
Aqueduct. Now to find our stonewort. Yote mentioned blood red petals. Just my luck. Well, I wasn't getting anything till they're gone. There's only one thing for it. Here it is. collect as much as I can before reinforcements arrive. Right. That should do it. Let's get these back to Yote.
Karen says she'll provide what she can for our voyage to Ash, and has even agreed to forgo payment. Until our return, that is.
Covered in nicks and lumps.
He swears he'll take his medicine. But it's up to you to see that he doesn't just take it with him.
Yote, I brought back all the stone and water I could find. Will this be enough?
My lord. Thank you. I'm sure it will serve us until we can find another source.
I'm very glad to hear it.
You and His Grace are very much alike, you know. You think only of how you might help others, and never of the danger to yourselves.
No more than you have minding my brother. You've risked a lot for him, and I thank you for it.
I am honored that you should say so, but I beg you, my lord, do not give too much of yourself for the sake of others. We could not afford to lose you.
I'll keep that in mind.
You and your brother really are alike, my lord. Though selflessness is a virtue, I beg you, please take more care of yourselves.
How do you split the sea?
So what do I owe the honor? The sound of ringing still. So we won. And who knows? Sangfornian, dear. Anything else?
Welcome to Dravosh, Sid. Our gate's always open for you and yours.
Nothing like the sound of steel on steel.
You're the one who butchered those Akashic fiends, aren't you? We're in your debt. Might only be a matter of time before the flood spills into the village, but until that day comes, we're not budging.
What do you think? I made myself a pair of bellows, just like Blackthorn showed us. Give him my thanks, will you? These things have stoked a fire under our asses just when our spark was about to go out.
Are those bellows easy to work, then?
They, take a bit of getting used to. I feel like an apprentice again. Wait to try out the new forge. Soon as I've sharpened up this little lot.
I want to play with the hammer, Daddy.
All right. It's about time you started learning the trade.
Did Blackthorn ever tell you? I still remember. Set us straight. There was a time, and each one but then while Blackthorn in the end don't ask me. And they still might be. And should those Akashi come calling again, safe travels.
It was a nasty gash that demon gave you. You sure it doesn't hurt?
Only when I laugh.
It's good to see the men back at work.
Aye, and roast chocobo on our plates again.
But what if the Akashic come again?
Then we'll give them another taste of Dravosh to steal.
These new air-powered furnaces burn through ore quicker than the old ones did. Our stockpile's not half what it was.
You'll get your precious ore. Soon as we can find some more seams that aren't ethered up to the eyeballs.
Here. You don't reckon we could get this old smelter back in working order, do you?
Easily. Sling that crystal. Drill a hole in the side for a set of bellows, and we'll be away.
We're miners, aren't we? Every day we head down to those tunnels knowing the next tremor might be the end of us. And it's not as if the whole mine's flooded.
Exactly. Don't reckon I could outrun a rockfall, but an Akashic, easy.
Sorry, no entry. The miners have got enough on their plates without visitors.
I have no reason to assume otherwise.
Well, then that changes everything. Clive, you must listen to this. Lawsman, tell him.
Do you recall when we spoke before on the divinity of Ultima? Well, it inspired me to delve deeper into the subject. And what I discovered appears to agree with the findings of His Grace.
You will recall that my quest to uncover Ultima's origins began with the mural at Phoenix Gate. But while I've always known it to be important, its secrets have heretofore eluded me. Now, however, I believe I know where to find the more complete example, one that will reveal all we seek.
Master Clive, have you ever in your travels chanced to hear of the Circle of Malleus? I would think not, if you have. But there was once a time when the faith flourished, the oldest known religion in the Twins, and though its popularity eventually waned on Storm, hints of its dogma remain embedded in more modern faiths such as the Crystalline Orthodox.
Wait, you said it waned on Storm. What of Ash?
Religious monuments are often torn down or repurposed when new faiths rise to prominence. But if no new faith arose, then perhaps the ancient temples might still stand. And so, you see now why I must accompany you to Walud.
It would appear the past still has much to teach us. Though in this case, it would not have been possible without the musings of Moss. To think that you carried a copy of my old mentor's chronicles all along. I am relieved to discover it in good hands.
I shall guard it with my life.
Joshua, if you're finished here, join me in the Ale Hall. I need to speak to everyone before we leave.
Right away.
If it please your grace, might I one day borrow the Chronicles for a short while?
Of course, Lawsman Hippocrates. You need but ask. My apologies.
By now you've all heard where we're going and why. So I won't bother you with the boring details, only the important ones. If we attempt to approach Stone here by sea, there's a good chance we'll be sighted and fall prey to the capital's artillery. So instead, we'll disembark on the southwest coast and make for Drake's Spine on foot. I say we, but it's highly likely the entirety of Ash is under the rule of Ultima. A large party would only attract unwanted attention, as well as slow our march and require supplies which may be difficult to obtain. Only Joshua and I will be going. And a scout. Preferably a good one. Gav, do you know of any?
You bet your ass I do. Might still borrow some of Lady Vivian's maps, though. Just in case, like.
Once you've dropped us off at the Shadow Coast, you need to retreat into neutral waters, fly merchant colors, and stay inconspicuous. If you sense any danger at all, you leave us behind and return to Storm.
Inconspicuous is my middle name. But like hell am I leaving anyone behind. The ship ain't going nowhere till your scurvy mugs are smiling on deck.
Jill, the Enterprise will appear a tempting target for Royalists and Pirates alike. You're to stop anyone boarding.
Don't worry. I'll keep the ship and her crew safe. You'll be needing passage home, after all.
But very well.
If there are no questions, I'll see you all at the docks.
Let me know when you're leaving. I want a word before you go.
Of course.
I might grab myself a mug of Maeve's mead. Settle me stomach, you know, before we take to the high seas.
Oh, don't tell me we're going to use awful things these days.
Certain we will find what we seek in Ash, and learn the truth of Ultima's origins.
Covered in nicks and lumps, the lot of them. It's a wonder they can still walk.
Canva lost? It can't be true.
Miss, can we read Miss Editor's story for a lesson?
How was she?
With Canva in the hands of a Kashyyyk, we'll need to find another port. Preferably one as well hidden as the Ironworks.
Greetings, Lord Marquis. His Grace and I. At first, it was my duty to him. Firebird's flame burn ever in your heart.
Is something wrong? Not at all. Honestly. Can't a man wish his friend farewell? Just wanted to let you know that I'll keep things in order while you're off saving the world.
I'll hold you to that.
Reckon it'll be a long walk to the capital if we follow the cliffs. I'll scout ahead, see if I can't find us an inland route.
Clive. There's something I've been meaning to ask. You took her icon, didn't you?
Yes, I did. She understood.
Oh, she understood. Understood that you decided to save the world all on your own, and that you'd die without her power. How dare you make her choose? You knew damn well she'd never refuse you. But I will. You can't keep pushing us away, Clive. The world is ours to save, not yours.
I used my gift because I thought it was the right thing to do.
And you truly believe this will save you? Will save us all?
I do.
Then so be it. Just don't forget, you're not alone.
I think I found us a trail. Did I miss something?
Only that Joshua didn't.
I don't get it. Always wanted to visit Ash.
We're in Waluda territory now. Don't expect a warm welcome.
Oh, I don't know, Clive. That castle over there looks inviting enough.
Shall we sample its inhabitants' hospitality?
Remember what I said about warm welcomes, Gav?
this place is as dead as Grieger's ghost.
Attack!
Amber all over again. Where the hell are the Royalists?
Seems you were right about that welcome after all, Clive. Delegation. We should send a warning to the others.
No. My uncle will have an eye on the coast. I trust he'll find a way to entertain any uninvited guests. Our mark is Drake's spine, and there's a lot of road between us and it. We press on to Stonehere.
Aye. You never know. It might not be a nest of slavering monsters.
Clive, you must go on ahead without me. This stronghold is as old as Phoenix Gate, perhaps older. It may yet hide Ultima's remaining secrets, and if we are to best him, they must be unearthed.
All right. Stay out of trouble.
I always do. Mostly.
You sure about this?
About leaving my brother on his own? Of course. Mostly.
Lady Vivian's map is so old, it's hard to tell which way is up. But if I'm right, we're not far from a village called Aestla.
Then we make our way there, resupply, and wait for Joshua.
This reeks like a mobile's arsehole. Though I'm guessing it's not the smell that will kill us.
Talk on.
hermit's breath. Don't look down, Torgal. That must be Aistla. What do you think, Clive?
Then we're too late.
Damn it. They're all turned. There's nothing we can do.
I wouldn't say nothing.
No quarter, Gav!
No quarter!
To me, Blade!
Gav. Gav!
Don't tell me there's more of the bastards.
Oh, fuck.
Have you come to watch, Odin?
Bound for Stonehenge. Good. My master awaits you in the capital, though I cannot allow you to attend him in your present state.
And how are you going to stop us?
Why, with this!
What did you do?
If the vessel would see the path opened, it has but to ask. I shall see that my master's prize is made.
Shit! No!
Clive? Would you mind telling me what the fuck just happened? Got to be. How are we supposed to get through that?
We seek an audience with the king. If his majesty wants me to come and ask him, then that is exactly what I'll do.
Before you go practicing your petition, we don't even know where the fucker went. How about we cool our heads and think this through, eh?
All right.
Maybe there's something here we can use. There's no one home, Clive.
Then let's find somewhere to sit down and look at the map.
I thought we got them all.
So did I.
Thank you.
not... Miss...
Whoa. Easy. Easy. We're not turned, all right? Forgive me for asking, but what went on here?
It all started when the skies changed. The elders said it was the Ark. One by one, people went mad. Minds taken by the ether. Till only I remained. By then, I was too far alone to run. And then the knights came. And I didn't know what to do.
And this, okay. Is
just a story. Something our grandparents told us when we misbehaved. About how the heavens would grow dark before the land took her last breath.
The end of the world.
You said the others went mad. But where did they go?
They all left. Drawn east to the tower. To Reverie. The elders. The healer. The blacksmith. My husband.
Thinking he did this.
Of course. Who else could it be? You were in Canva. You saw what he did to the people.
But then what about her? How come her nut hasn't cracked?
The baby, perhaps? Could be protecting her from the ether. I can't think of any other explanation.
You mean... it's a bearer?
It won't matter what it is once Ultima's magic takes hold. Time's running out.
This tower... that's where we'll find the king.
I knew it. It's the same as Phoenix Gate. Which means at the end of these stairs should be... The mural is complete. Ultima and his vessel, Ifrit, Garuda, Ramu, Shiva, Titan, Muhammad, Odin. Even Leviathan the Lost is here. But where is the Phoenix? The Founder. So that's what you want, isn't it, Ultima?
So that's how it's gonna be then.
I'm not asking, Gav. I need you to stay with Edda.
What?
I must do this alone. If I don't return, you're to find Joshua and make for the Enterprise. Understood?
Aye. Don't you go dying on me. Sid's name suits your miserable mug better than mine.
Don't worry. I haven't finished with it yet.
If Barnabas is controlling the Akashic, then wherever he goes, they'll follow. And so will I.
Thank you.
something there. I can feel it. But now's not the time.
This is it, boy.
Aye, it's a dangerous world out there.
Best not.
You'll not find a better price than that.
Is that all?
The stews.
So, what'll it be? Not bad, if I do say so myself. Anything else?
Sid ran from Stone here to chase his dream. They always knew it'd lead him back there in the end.
Orcs? In Randalar? But what of the Fist?
Where it is, they held the walls. But only just.
Allow me to educate you. Here's the latest information I have. Here you are. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
How do you split?
I've come for you, Barnabas. Stay close. own.
Yeah.
If I were Barnabas, where would I be? The top. So I could look down on the world. What was that thing? Hopefully there aren't any more.